Hello friends, I am Hardik Patel. Welcome back to Django tutorial. In this video, I am going to talk about model image field. So what is image field? So similar to the char field, integer field, there is one more field, that is image field, which provides the functionality to upload image from the front end. It can be stored in the different storage like file storage, and path will be stored in the database. And then next, whenever you want to use, you can use it, right? And what this image field does, it takes few responsibilities like character field. So it takes the responsibility of checking the length, right? The same way, what image field does, it checks the whatever file is provided, is image is it a proper image or not, right? So that's how it works. So ultimately what it does, it just validates the image. And how image field is built, which is built on file field, and file field extended by char field. So ultimately this is the char field. So actually it is saving the string, whatever it is, the path, right? Path will be stored in the field, but at that path actual file will be stored. So we have to mention where we want to store the data, store the files, store the images, right? So to do that, there are few arguments we can provide to image field. So because of that, it can understand where to store. And image field, how we can work with this image field or file field into the views and from the front end side, right? In the template, I mean. So let's check it out quickly using example. So this is the profile model, and let me show you first what is existing. I'm running this server, and let me refresh this page. Yeah, so I'm already logged in. I'm clicking on this Hardik, so it will redirect me to profile page of Hardik, right? So here these are the five fields which we can see, right? But I want to add one more field here, that is profile pic. So we can add a profile picture, right? So I am going to add one more field here. So I am giving just name that picture. Whatever you want to give name, you can give it, right? Models dot image field. Look at this, there are so many fields are there, but file field also we can use. If you want to validate yourself, then definitely you can use file field as well. But if you don't want to validate yourself, then you can use image field. And image field provides two more argument extra, that is height field and width field, right? So I will explain that also what it does. So first of all, whenever you create this image field, max length must be provided. And how many characters you want to save. Let's say for example, if you have longer path or maybe long name, and in your case, if you want to save whatever file name coming from the front end, it may be a longer, right? So you don't want to take a risk. So you can create 2555. That means maximum length. But if you know that you are providing the path name, so whatever file name is coming from the front end, you are just renaming that to your convention, and then you are storing, right? So that means path name will be sorted down, right? Shortened. So in that case, you can set this 100 or whatever it is. But for now, I am putting this 255 maximum. Okay. Then another thing. Let me explain what is this height field. So you just need to mention the name here, like picture in single quote, picture height. So picture height named field will be automatically auto populated in this profile model. So what it will does, like whenever you add any picture to profile, and save method will be called, that means like profile dot save, right? So save method will be called, and at that time this height of that image will be calculated, and that will be stored in picture height field. Same way for width fields, right? So in picture width, like you can create one more field here. You don't need to create explicitly, but this will be automatically populated and it will be stored in your database. But if you don't want this, you can remove it. I am not taking it right now in our case, and because we don't need, right? In this case, we just want to upload an image. Now, one more argument, that is upload to. So here you need to provide a path. If you don't provide path, then it will be stored into the media root directory directly. And what is media root directory? That is mentioned in settings.py. Here it is. So there are two arguments are parameters are available in settings.py. Two configurations you can provide: media URL and media root. So as we haven't provided full path here, so what it will does? It will create media directory in this project folder here itself, right? Whenever we upload first file. And what is media URL? So media URL is basically like whatever URL will be your files, it will be, this is like prefix, or you can say base URL for any media file. Okay, so you will understand, I will explain that when we run this project. Okay, so upload to. So in upload to, if you don't provide anything, this file will be uploaded and will be stored in media directory directly. But if you provide some like path like this, pictures slash, then it will be stored in subdirectory of media named pictures. So that means media slash pictures slash and then file names. Another facility Django provides, that is let's say for example you are creating any application for events or maybe articles. Then articles can be stored by year wise, then month wise, and the date wise, right? So for that you can provide like this: capital Y slash percentage M slash percentage D and then slash. So what it will do, it will every time it will check the year, month and date. So in this sequence, if the folder is not there, then it will be created and then image will be stored in that directory. But if it is there, then it will be, it will store normally, right, in the same directory. Okay, so this is the way I am putting like this only. Okay, now this is ready. We don't need to do anything here other than this. This is very basic and simple, right? Now how can we use this picture in front end? Okay, so let's say for example this is our one more thing I wanted to explain, that is, so whenever you image field, so what it will do, whenever you upload any image, it will validate, right? So for validation, there are some requirement, there is some dependency of imaging library. And what is the imaging library for Python? That is pilo. So you have to install this, like pip install pilo. So if you will install pilo, that will be solved. Okay, now we have added one more field, so we have to create migrations and then we have to migrate their migration into the database. So we have to run two commands here: make migrations. Okay, here if you don't provide default values, then it will ask for default values, because we have already created few employees and for them we haven't provided any picture. So what I will do here, null is equal to 2, right? It's okay if you don't provide any profile picture. So null true and false and blank true. So I'm just canceling this. Again, I am creating make migration. Yeah, so migration is created. Now let me migrate that. Okay, so field is added in database as well. Now let's run this project first. Okay, here it is. So right now I'm not seeing any field here. So what I can do here, this is the page for profile.html. In this case, I can add one more row here, like tr and then th. What will be the header? The profile picture, right? And then td, and inside there I can provide image, right? And we need to provide src here. And what is the field name? Object dot picture dot url. So image field has one more property, that is url. If you don't provide use this dot url, then it will provide you the only file name. Okay, so you have to use this url field whenever you are using this on src. Okay, so okay, now so this is done. Let me refresh this page. What happens? Okay, this is giving an error. So picture attribute has no file associated with it. Okay, so let me remove this now. All right, so for what we have to check here, that is like we have to write condition here. If object dot picture, right, if picture is available, then we can use here like this, else it will be blank, right, like this. Only picture is available, then only you use this, like this. Now if you click on edit profile, we want here one more field here to upload an image. Okay, now let's check it out what happens. So this is the views.py, and for uploading or updating employee, there is one view we have created, that is yes, profile update, and we have used update view, that is generic view, right? And in that case, what we need to provide? Three things: fields, template name and success url. So these two things we need to we don't need to change, but we need to add one more field here, that is picture. And what will happen here, as we have used update view and we have also provided one instance of profile, so this update view, generic view, will understand that is this picture field is coming from profile model. And also this update view knows that this picture is an image field. So whenever we are going to render that form automatically by this update view in this profile update.html, it will render as an image field, sorry, like file upload input field, right, file input field, so you can upload the image. Okay, so now I'm saving that, and now I'm just refreshing this page. So what will happen? Yeah, look at this, picture is available now, and just we need to upload here. So whatever image you select and just update employee, yeah, so what happened? Is it uploaded or not? So let's check it out here. Is media directory is created or not? Not right. So there is something missing. And what is that? Yes. Okay. So one more thing just I missed out. That is this is profile update.html, right? So where is that? Here it is. Okay, so whenever you are uploading a file, you have to mention here ink type and multi-part form data. So whenever you have anything like file field in your form, then you have to mention this. Encryption type is multi-part form data, because file data can be sent in a request using this encryption type only. Okay, so you have to mention this. Now let's check it out. Okay, now it is file is uploaded, but it is not showing here. Why? Because there is one issue which we haven't taken care yet. Okay, so let me explain that as well. So if you can see here, this when we refresh this page, this web page was trying to get this resource from the server, and that is the URL. This is the URL, right? Let me copy this to here and just hold on a second. I will explain that. Yeah. So what happened here? It is saying that page not found. Why? Because by default, Django doesn't serve media directories or media files similar to the static files. Static files can be served by Django automatically, but if you want to serve media files, then you have to mention something. You have to write URLs in syntax.py. But when you deploy this project in your server at that place, you are serving those media files directly through the Apache server, maybe Nginx server, whatever web server you are using, right? Whenever you are in debug mode, you are developing an application, at that time you are not using or you are not serving those media files through web server, right? We are using just manage Django admin to run the server. So in that case, what you need to do here, go to the urls.py, root urls.py, and then you need to just include from django.conf.urls.staticmodule, and then static method you have to import, and also you have to import conf import settings, and then this URL patterns is our original URL patterns, right? But you have to append few more URL patterns through this setting, this static method. So just call like this static, inside that what will be the prefix, then settings dot media URL, and what is the second argument, that is document root, and just provide settings dot media root. Okay, so this is the thing which you need to do. Now this media URL, like /media/, and whatever media root is there, look at this. This media folder is created, inside their pictures is also created, year folder is also created, month, date, and then file name, right? So now as you can see here, after media pictures /2018/06/02 and then file name will be served through this line, right? Now let's refresh this page. Look at this. Now image is available, right? And if I refresh this page, here also that image will be appeared. Okay. Let me just give height and width here. Just height 200 and refresh this. Okay. Now if you click on edit profile, the form is rendered automatically by Django itself. Now if you want to clear this image, you just select that and choose another file and just update employee, right? So that way you can do here. So that's very simple thing. So you don't need to do, or you don't need to write any extra things for yourself, because the generic views, forms, everything is taken care of or taking care for you. Okay, so that's it from this video. Something like this. If you have anything to understand, you don't understand yourself, and if you want me to explain that things, just post those things in comment section, maybe or in a discussion forum. So I will take care of that by making the video. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. If you have liked this video and if you have liked this channel, please subscribe. So I am posting more and more videos regarding this Django, Django REST framework, and also I am going to put more videos regarding AngularJS, not AngularJS but latest Angular 5. Okay, so thanks again for watching.